Okay, we have a fun one today. What we're going to do is we're going to remove these pencil lines from this white background so that we can have it sitting on a layer by itself. This is great because you don't have to use a multiply, and then you can go ahead and color the pencil lines in whatever color you want after the fact using preserve transparency. So I'm going to show you this with a very subtle gray pencil. And then I'm going to show you one with a marker sketch. So let's jump right into it. Okay, so we have this image. What we're going to do is we have to clean it up. So if you look at the background, you can see that it's not really white. So for the technique that I'm doing, we need to have that background white. So what you want to do is I'll navigate up here to show you where it's at. We're going to go Image, Adjustments, Levels. Command L is the keyboard shortcut. I highly recommend that you memorize these because you're going to use it all the time. Then we come over here. See this white eyedropper right here? You have a black, mid-gray, and white. That corresponds to each one of these triangles here. Okay, it allows you to set the white point, the black point, and the mid value. If I want the pencil value to stay gray, well, I'm not going to modify this triangle here because you can see it's going to change the value. So let's say I really want it to stay relatively light, but I do have to get this background out. So I'm going to click on the white eyedropper. And if you look, I'm going to come over here to these areas that appear to be gray, and I'm going to tap to remove and set the white point. And to be safe, I might pull this over just a tiny bit more. Now, if you look, there's subtle values inside of this pencil sketch. I don't want to lose all of that. But I do want to knock out that background. So I'm going to go ahead and click OK. Now, what I'm going to do is take this lasso tool and I'm going to draw around his head. And then I'm going to invert the selection, which is Command Shift I. On PC, that's a Control Shift I. Okay, now what I'm going to do is, since I'm on a background layer, what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit the letter D to bring up my colors by default over here. Then I'm going to fill it with the background color. How do you do that? You hold down Command key and then hit the Delete key. And I just filled it in white. Now, if it were white before, hopefully I didn't have to do that, but that's just a safety net to make sure I really knocked out a lot of that stuff back to white. Now, let's get to the fun part. Let's go ahead and get this line separated from the white. Let's navigate to the channels where you see the RGB channel. You'll see RGB and then you'll see red, green, and blue underneath. I want you to put your cursor on top where it says RGB, hold down the Command key or Control if you're PC. Click your mouse, and what it's going to do is select the value of the image. Okay. What I'm going to do now is go to Select, Inverse. Now the selection has been inverted. I'm going to go back to Layers. I'm going to create a new layer. Now, what I'm going to do is fill with the value black. I'm looking at my foreground color. So now to fill with foreground color, you hold option key, tap delete, and it fills with black. Now I'm gonna deselect. Now you're looking at this and you're thinking, okay, the image looks darker. The reason is, if I turn off the background, this is what the actual line is now. It's separated. But what it's doing, it's sitting on top of this background layer, so it's getting darker. So I have two options. I could put a layer above the background and fill it with white to see what it looks like, or I can fill the background layer. Okay. So what I'm gonna do now is I'll just go ahead and create a new layer, and then what I'm gonna do is fill it with the background layer. That's Command key, delete, and it fills. Now what you have is the value looks very similar to what you had before. The beauty of this is, layer one, it is isolated, meaning it's all by itself. Okay. Also, what's cool is if I hit the preserve transparency or lock transparency pixels, so if I lock this down, if I take a brush, and I'm just going to pick any kind of paintbrush, and if I came over here and select a color and I start to paint down, let me turn the smoothing off for a moment. Okay, and I'm going to make my brush larger. I could actually paint the pencil lines in with a different color. This is really cool. Okay. So I can go back in. So all of this, the line is going to be very subtle, and it looks like I drew the pencil lines inside of Photoshop. So let's do this one more time. It's going to go a little faster. I just want you to see the difference now if we're using a marker sketch. Okay. So here what we have is a Copic marker sketch that I did using the Copic liners and some Japanese brush pens. Now what I want to do is same thing. We're going to go to levels. So this time I'm going to use the keyboard shortcut, Command L. Now, let's see how we can play around with this. I'm going to grab the white eyedropper, come down here and select these areas to try to knock out that value. I can still see a little bit of that edge, so I'm going to take this triangle and move it over just a tiny bit. Move it over a little bit more. Okay. So it looks like I'm eating into the gray a little bit. So let me show you something else here. Now, see these black lines? Because they are black, and I did that with ink. This is different from the other image. I'm going to take this black triangle and slide it over because I do want to set the black point, and I want it to have that sharp, crisp pop that looks like the actual sketch. Okay, so I just set that to black. So now I just gave some contrast to my black lines. Okay, now I have an option, one last thing I can do. This middle gray triangle, I can shift the value of the middle values lighter or darker if you had to make any adjustments here. Okay, so I'm just gonna leave it about here. That's good enough for me. I'm gonna click OK. Now, what I can do that I didn't do previously is I can come up to filter. And I can go down to sharpen, and I'm just going to hit sharpen, and that's it. I'm going to come back up to filter. I'm going to hit sharpen again, Command F. So it's just giving a little bit of an edge, crisper visual to the line work. And if you want, you can do it at least one more time. That should be enough. Okay. Now, what I'm going to do is go ahead and extract it, same way we did previously. Go over to channels, command key on the composite layer, which is the RGB on top. Click with your mouse, it's loaded. Keyboard shortcut to inverse is command shift I. Go back to your layers, create a new layer, and I'm going to fill it. Again, if I tap the letter D, it'll go back to default colors. Also, let me just show you if you click on this little icon over here, the black and white, you can see it shows you letter D. This will also go back, okay, meaning default back. Let's go ahead. Now I'm going to fill. And also, let me show you where fill is if you don't want to use the keyboard shortcuts. It's under edit, fill. Okay. Here, you have an option. It's under contents. You can use content aware, foreground color, background color. So I'm going to go ahead and use foreground color, which is black. Again, let's go ahead and deselect. It looks really heavy, but that's because we have it layered on top of the image underneath. Let me go ahead and fill. I'm going to do command delete this time, and I'm filling with the background color. And now I have my sketch on its own layer. Okay. And this is what we have. Okay, so I think that was a fun one today. I know you guys should be able to use this in multiple situations. Later on, maybe I'll come back and show you guys how to get things set up if you're a comic book artist. But for now, I think that's going to allow you guys to take your sketchbooks into Photoshop and get those lines separated. Don't have to use a multiply layer. Yeah, it's a fun one. So if you found this video helpful, please don't hesitate to go down below, hit the like and the subscribe button. Also, if you guys have any suggestions for tutorials that you want to see me do in the future, please go down to the comments section below. Go ahead and list the things that you want me to do, and I'll try to get to those as soon as I can. In the meantime, peace.